natural advantage is proportional to the inverse of the angular velocity ratio. So we haven't talked about the angular velocity ratio, so let's talk about that now. So let me draw a four-bar mechanism. We have point A here, point B here. Let me zoom up on this. And we have O2 and we have O4. So what I'm going to do here is find, so if this is I12, and this is I14. And remember, this is I34 up here. And this is I23 here. So to find 24, what you do is draw a line like this through 23 and 34. And you draw a line like this through 12 and 14. And you get where those intersect, I24. All right. So if I have my omega 2 looking like this here, I know that that drives this down like so. So this will be my velocity of I24. And that means for link 4, it has to move in this direction also. That's omega 4. What I'm going to do is drop down these virtual links here. So I'm going to draw a line that's perpendicular. Let me draw another line here that's perpendicular. And I'm going to label this point here D prime, and this point here A prime. So those are virtual links. And if I have this right here, this is going to be the velocity of A prime. And B prime velocity has to be the same when these things are perpendicular to the other links. So this is B prime, B D prime. All right. So let me just write here that VA prime equals VB prime. That doesn't mean that VA and VB equal each other. It just means if I create those virtual links that they equal each other. All right. Now there's these things called transmission angles. So I have transmission angles here. So this angle right here is called nu. And this angle right here is called mu. So this is nu, and this is mu. And these are transmission angles. All right? So nu is defined as the transmission angle between links 2 and 3. And mu is defined as the transmission angle between links 3. Okay. And they are the acute angles, i.e. less than 90 degrees. So remember, there's the obtuse angles and the acute angles. And so you looked at the one that's less than 90 degrees. So if you looked at this right here, for example, you don't want that angle right there, you want this angle right here to divide your transmission angle. Let me zoom up on that. Okay? So this here is the obtuse angle, this is the acute angle. So over here, if you look at this one here, this angle here would be the obtuse, and this is the acute. All right, so you look for that. All right, so let me continue on with this and say that if VA prime equals VB prime, then I know that VA prime equals VB prime. And if I look at this right here, that means that omega 2 times this distance from O2 up to A prime equals omega 4 O2 to B prime. So let's let that sink in for a second. So I know that if I have these things here, perpendicular, perpendicular, at this instant in time, VA prime equals VB prime. I can calculate what that is because I know the distance from O2 to A prime and O4 to B prime. So I can set omega 2 times O2 A prime equals omega 4 O2 times B prime. Let's see what else we can do.
That's O4 B prime.
O4, yeah, thank you. O4 B prime. Yes, thank you. And this right here is omega 2. If I look at this, it's O2A times sine of nu, which equals omega 4 O4B sine of mu.
Is it B prime or not?
No, it's, so let's look at this for a second. A prime here, this O2 to A prime, so this distance right here, if I use nu here, I can find out, and I use, I know what this distance is here, O2 to A, because that distance there is the link length A. If I know the transmission angle, I can project that as the sine of it. All right? Likewise, I know what this is over here, this is C. If I know the transmission angle, mu, I can project that sine of this and use O4B to get the distance O4 to B prime. That's what I'm doing there.
So is that equation A supposed to be prime?
No, it's a smear. And I wish I had some white out. Oh, prime. Okay. So it's O2A sine of nu equals omega 4 times O4B sine of nu. Right. Okay. So this right here means that I can write omega 2 times A times sine of nu, which equals omega 4 times C times sine of mu. And this is what we call an angular velocity ratio. M sub v, which equals omega 4 over omega 2, which equals A sine of nu, C sine of nu. So that's the angular velocity ratio. What I want you to note here is that M sub v approaches 0 when that transmission angle nu approaches 0, and M sub B approaches infinity when our mu equals 0. And we're going to use that to our advantage when we talk about mechanical advantage. But remember that we like to work in terms of instant centers. So let me just say aside, in terms of instant centers, can use I24 to get M sub v. And we do this by knowing that the velocity of I24 equals omega 2 and I12 I24, which equals omega 4 I14 I2. Alright. So remember, angular velocity ratio equals omega 4 over omega 2. So that means that I have I12 I24 divided by I14 I24. That ratio is my angular velocity ratio. Okay? So let me just write, we will use this to find mechanical